What up, my devil? Sensei-tutum here with another video for ya. So another week, another Ethereum video. You know, when I started doing videos a couple weeks ago and kind of in my mind wanting to do weekly videos, I didn't really expect to do ETH every week, but maybe that's what I'll do, just because I keep wanting to update you guys, because I've already put you in a certain, you know, I've already given you a certain amount of information. I want to give you the more updated information. Maybe this leads to more videos, more days a week, or maybe I just switch it up when I feel like it. So, but I'm gonna try to get through this really quick today, as I have been trying to do. So if I talk too fast, maybe you can slow it down when you're watching it, but my natural inclination is to talk for like an hour, so I'll probably try to get through it as quick as I can. So I noticed I was speaking quickly last video. All right, so Ethereum, this is where we left off last week, exactly right here, right? This is the exact same chart. I haven't touched it, is what I meant to say. Now, before we come back and reanalyze what has happened here, I think it's worthwhile to talk about Bitcoin a little bit. So this is the current Bitcoin chart. We have broken a major downturn trend line through nice resistance. In addition to that, a confluence area where we've broken through on a big trend line down, right? This is generally a very important event on Bitcoin, and this is not something that I'm just now looking at. In fact, as you can see here, I was showing members that we were approaching much earlier than this, right? So, and when I'm showing this, it's not, you know, people always want to take a chart or take an analysis in the light that they want to take it in. They never want to just, if you want to get better at this theory, when you look and listen at someone that's trying to teach you, you should open your mind to what they're telling you. So showing this is not showing that it's 100% probability it's going to go down or 100% probability it's going to go up. It's showing that we're reaching an important area. And once what, and then when you see what happens at that important area, you have now garnered important information, right? And this is absolutely was a tradable event. You could have shorted it. I certainly didn't, but you could have shorted this, right? And it wouldn't have worked out for you. And I wouldn't have faulted you one bit, because it would have worked out here. It would have worked out here. You know, it's like people are so retroactive in trading. Anyway, but long before this, I shared this count with the team, now the members, and I will tell you that when I shared it, at the time I didn't love it, and this pitchfork's messed up, this should be there, and actually, that's very relevant information, at the time that I shared it, I said, you know, I didn't really love it, I wanted another one more leg down. And do you know how many times that happens in these types of corrections, these major corrections, where it's like, I just want one more leg down. I just want one more leg down. I just want one more leg down. One more. Oh, I just want to make a new low. You know, this shit happens all the time, right? So now, of course, the opposite happens as well, because you know why? The market is not here to be your friend. The market is not here to make it easy on you. But if you understand those things, you can make it easy on yourself, right? If you understand that it could turn here, or that this could have just been a three wave, as I try to scream from the rooftops for people, right? That it could be a major top there, right? If you stop trying to force your what you want onto the chart, what you want into the analysis, and just open your mind, it's, you know, it's helpful. And of course, that's great information for myself as well. Why? Because this was the only count at the time, and by the way, this could still end up being wrong. It could reveal itself in the future. But when you see that this is really the only, like, slap you in the face count is the term that I've come up with and like to use. Because if it's not a slap you in the face count, then what the fuck do you need it for? How does it help you? Why? Because you're not going to go in there and solve the riddle that no one else can solve. And if you do, you just got lucky. It's when it's easy for you. It's when it's easy for you. Anyway, so I had posted at the time, yeah, my gut is one more down. And I've said many times, my gut is stupid. So that was the Bitcoin count. Now, and this was, you know, probably posted on the 27th. Let's see. Let's look at the calendar real quick. 27th, was that before or after my last video? 27th would have been before my last video. So this was before my last video with Ethereum, where I told you, based on the count, that I didn't, you know, so same, right? That I thought there should be one more leg down. Now, the chart, the Ethereum chart, supported that and maybe potentially still does support that better. Remember, they are not the same asset. They are very correlated. And I wanted to cover that in this video. So, but moving on. So, speaking of correlation, we have a split screen here. Bitcoin, Ethereum. Major downtrend line has broken here. Have we broken it on Ethereum? Not yet, right? Okay, so is that significant? Potentially, let you decide. Put the feather in your cap and you can wait that, right? And before we, you know, move on from, because after we do this comparison, we'll get right to that Bitcoin, that Ethereum chart again. But it should be noted, base trend channel. Do you know what a base trend channel is? I had some guy comment on one of my videos before. It's a, I don't remember, one of the EWI guys. That's a Prector or somebody channel. No, it's not. Bullshit. This was fucking, this existed in the 1930s when Ralph Nelson Elliott devised this theory. It's the, they're all the channeling, if you listen to Elliott, is an extremely important. I mean, if you look at Twitter, nobody fucking understands it, but anyway, base trend channel. And it is not an insignificant fact that we are reaching the top. Same as the downtrend line here. Not saying that it's going to stop it. Not saying that it's going to blast right through it. Either is viable. And yeah, it's a fuck. I curse too much, don't I? And I'm not getting through this fast enough. So let's hurry up. But it's a shortable event. Let's just put it that way. Do I feel strongly about it? Mm-mm. No. After this video, I mean, you'd have to short it today around now. It's a decent spot, man. It's a decent little short trade. It's just a trade. But anyway, that's on the Bitcoin chart. Ethereum, no different, if not even better. But that's beside the fact. We have broken that downtrend line. We didn't break it here. So, but let's just look and see how correlated we are and what happens when we break downtrend lines in the past. Bitcoin. Broken. Actually, let's just take the painter's tool thing because it will stay on my cursor. You guys get to see me try to draw. Broken trend line, what happened? Major move. Broken trend line, what happened? Major move. Oh shit, now I can't move it. Broken trend line, oops. Broken trend line, what happened? What happened? What happened? So it has, in the past, when Bitcoin breaks these trend lines, it has been significant, right? And that's why I always show these. If you go back to this, I guarantee you I showed a chart just like that one to the members. Just like, where'd the other one go? Just like this one, just like this one to the members. It's simple. It's really simple. Can you do that? Did you just start looking at TA yesterday? Can you do that? I bet you can. Simple things have power. And yeah, the more complicated you get, the worse off you are, in my opinion. But two, you're into Elliott Wave. Elliott Wave is extremely simple. You guys complicate it. Anyway, so what does Ethereum do when Bitcoin breaks down trend lines? All right, so we can see my cursor on both sides. My crosshairs will be over here on Ethereum, but keep an eye on, we'll talk about both charts. So this point, same thing. This point, same thing. Since back here, and this is May 21, highly correlated assets. They weren't so much before that. So let's go ahead and slide that over and slide that over. You know, see how they were quite different. This sort of, Ethereum sort of ran up and blew off, and Bitcoin sort of ran up and had a topping pattern. So yeah, they weren't exactly highly correlated before that, but since that, after that point, they were still what happened when, let's say, Bitcoin broke downtrend here. Significant move on both. Let's see, Bitcoin's next one was here. This was sort of a triple top, then significant move on both though. Almost identical. So essentially, it has been a significant identifier of a low, not necessarily the strength of the following move on either chart, but it has been a very significant, the break of the downtrend line on Bitcoin has been a very significant tell on lows being in, right? So again, that doesn't tell you exactly what's going to happen, but that's a useful piece of information. How can you craft a strategy around useful pieces of clarity, right? The markets are moving. To me, you know, I mean, of course, I know if you're on Twitter, and I know if you listen to most people that do technical analysis, it's just they got the cheat codes and they can see the world. They're watching the Matrix on the freaking chart, like the numbers on the chart, and they can see everything. To me, the way I move through the markets is through fog, and I hit patches of open space, and I use those patches of open space to anchor myself, to get to my destination. It's the way it works for me. So to me, that is a point of clarity, right? And that's simple, right? Anything complex is still foggy usually, right? Okay, so we have determined that is potentially a very significant thing for Bitcoin to break this downtrend line. Now, every time that happened, this also broke hit, you know, this Ethereum chart also broke their downtrend, its downtrend line. It has not done so at this point. And not to mention, there are, you know, there can be fake outs along the way. I mean, there were on the Bitcoin down, right? So let's just go to this chart. Look, so depending on how you want to draw this thing, like if you drew it here to start, actually, I'd say that's probably the best way to draw it. Fake out. Looks like it's going to catch support. Not, we're back in. Fake out. So, you know, but now we have broken out and held. That's always a beautiful trade there. And then if you wanted to get more aggressive with the drawing, and, you know, and this is the things you do at times, is you get more and more aggressive that, you know, you faked out. And this was significant as well. And then rejected. And then fake out. And do we hold? Right. So, you know, while this could be a short, you know, a higher quality short, I wouldn't necessarily want to be in it, try to be in it through this level. Maybe you can long again, you know, and this is just easy. If you're on the market, you can make these trades. I would probably want to be looking at the charts at no higher than a 15 minute, probably ideally 5 minute, if I'm going to make these trades. And I very may well. That's, you know, there's, you know, on the lower degree, this is getting longer than I wanted to be. On the lower degree, there's a lot of things I want to look for before I take entry. So what I'm telling you here is the 30,000 foot view, right? If you want to know about these lower degree things, you just gotta, join the Discord. I don't know what to tell you. So let's get to the ETH chart. This video is going to be way longer than I want it to be. And so I'm never going to be Twitter famous, guys. You got to have short videos that with no substance. That's how you get Twitter famous or YouTube famous. Anyway, this was the count. Let's see if we can, how we feel about this now. Okay, let's get rid of these fibs real quick. All right, so we had now this was a second option to the one that I had shown you the previous week where this three was in. And I told you 50-50, same. But I like that. I liked the one that is still on the chart better. Now, this is the base trend. This is the temporary channel. Temporary channel is a minimum guideline. We've broken through that. Not necessarily a bad thing. However, we are well into the meat of the base trend. We certainly don't want to get on this side of it. That is clear violation of guidelines. However, I don't really always generally love getting into it though. The way that this chart plays, you know, look at this shit. You don't think that happens? Okay, so it could still be the four at this degree. could, not saying it is, could. And could is usually useless fucking information. Anything could be possible, right? So let me just, so let's see what we think about the larger one. It's gonna be even worse. Broken the base trend. Of course, with the swift nature of the move, that's sort of potentially not the most useful channel. So in both cases, we've really just broken it. The minimum guideline, and the minimum guideline being the backside of the temporary channel. But if you break it too much, you should start to think the other way. Now, so it's getting, it's definitely big enough, right? We've got some nice divergence forming. Now, coming up into this resistance here. Now we're getting a little outside the Elliott wave. This 50. This is an algorithmic. Algo, SR, trading vol, important level. Circling back to Elliott wave, perception of things. I can tell you this, the expectation was a sideways. It's no longer the case. Let's count this on its own merits. I'm not going to sit here and tell you that, oh yeah, you know, if there's overlap and confusion, it's usually corrective, which many times it is. However, if you look at if you look at bottoms, significant bottoms, they're real hard to tell the difference between a one and a corrective move. And that's, you know, people that actually understand the theory and are good at the theory, that's something they struggle with. So if we count this here, we'll just say, take this as a swing. This is a swing. Could be a three swing move finishing. Could be some sort of 1-2-1-2 as well. I do think that we'll definitely react. Well, definitely is a strong word. I think we'll, I mean, I hate using strong words in this, but I will, I'll stick to definitely as far as from a TA perspective, react at that level. And the big tell will be what happens after. When you get to the, around this area. But it doesn't look like an A of a four. So in my opinion, and it's still 50-50, man, whether this is 3 of this degree or the 3 of the degree that I deleted. But I would say that the 4 is going to be finishing. Should it be a 4, it will be finishing in this area. See, if we get to that 50, we break this downtrend line. It could just be a fake out. Should this reverse, it's not going to be sideways anymore, I don't think. Not at all. But I don't want a bottom call here. But this is all the markets kind of did this to me with this expecting one more leg, and they haven't been there. And again, like I explained, this happened so many times, and this video is way longer than it's supposed to be. I just wish, I don't know, guys. I know you want me to tell you, like, oh, you know what? I'm going to make this declaration. I'm not prepared to do that just yet. This could still be a freaking bull trap, because I know that there's, you know, the people that are like, ah, see, you thought it was going down. I know those people are out, right? The blind maxis. But, you know, the going to zero people, they usually, they're always fun to get fucked as well. And then there's the idiots like me that just one more leg. And I, by the way, I don't do that all the time. Just did it here, and it happens enough. But this is significant, man. I'm going to go with ever so slightly. I'm going to lean the bull camp. I don't know how that's going to play out, because these lows at these significant bottoms are often really fuckery. So I'm going to look to the fact that we have broken this downtrend line and held it for a significant amount of time. If we close today's candle, this is Saturday, I'm recording this. If we close today's candle above this, it's going to be... because all those other times... two closes above. This one had two closes above at that fake out level. Okay. Three closes above, fourth down. Okay, so if we stay above this for 5 days, I honestly think, based on this, it's just very significant, the level, the way that we've broken it, the way that we retested it. I'm ever so slightly... if I have to give 100%, two options, bottom in, bottom not in, I'm going to go 68.6. No, 61.8. I'm going to go 61.8 bottom in. And, 61.8 bottom in. This is not insignificant, but there are a lot of things that could still... and this is now, we're looking at the Bitcoin chart. There's still a lot of things that can be an impediment. So we showed the sort of the confluency we were coming up on, and no surprise, same here. 50, base trend. This one happens to be a low volume node. Other side was a high volume node. They can act the same as far as what they will do to price when we meet there. So, it's high volume. Coming with a low volume patch there. So there's something to pay attention to. Definitely significant as well. But won't get any more details about it because the video is long, and that's what member videos are for. So about to record this week's member video. If you're still here and you want to check it out, you got to join the Discord. It's going to be in the educational section, and it's going to be a reminder about how I use pitchforks. So should be a good one. All right, boys. Talk to you soon. Toot out.